Hello and today, welcome to my channel. In this video, we're going to take a look at where Manchester United are 20 years from now. That's according to Football Manager 2018. Let's waste no more time, jump in the TARDIS and get on with the show. So here we are, folks. If you haven't noticed already, Manchester United lie currently second in the Premier League on May the 1st, 2037. So still a little bit of time left. Maybe, just maybe, they can snatch the trophy from some other team's grasp. And if you haven't also noticed, currently on the right-hand side, this is your key employees right now. Sergio Conceição is your manager. So no more Mourinho. He's the gaffer. Felix George, obviously these players probably don't mean anything to you. These are your captains, key players, etc. And this is a quick overview. So there is at least one, maybe two Premier League titles. We'll take a look at that in just a second. But let's jump in and take a look at your senior squad. If you have checked out my previous videos, I didn't really set up the layout as I'd hoped. But after a little bit of time, I've managed to come up with a screen that seems a little bit more detailed. And obviously, I'm not manager, so all these abilities can't be seen, and I can't really give you any financial advice without taking over the reins. And I don't want to do that. I don't want to mess with the flux here, because this is something that maybe I'll let them sit for a little longer and see where they are 30 years later. But anyway, here we are. It's your squad. No more David De Gea, but you have a Spanish goalkeeper, 33-year-old Miguel Flores. He's your man. Let's take a look at your most expensive player today. Michel Diaby from Ivory Coast. Young 23-year-old player. He seems to be super key. And you've got a Turkey striker. Turan Ariki. 75 million also. Fabian Perez, another striker from Colombia. 73 million. So obviously the Brexit rules doesn't seem to be causing too much trouble. There's a lot of foreign international folks in here. Not many English. Sean McKay knocking on 6 million. Alex Marshall, £50 million. What place does he play in a position? I'm trying to see. It looks like a striker. Three caps, two goals. So let's take a look at how you fared over the seasons. First bit of good news, no relegations the past 20 years. Premier League consistently. Start with the 2017-18 season. Looks like you picked that bad boy up. So this season, that's a bit of good news. Third place, followed by another trophy in the 2019-2020 season. 25-26, another trophy, another championship. So that's three at the past 20 years. I'm not sure if you're going to be accepting that as good enough. So let's take a look at your managers over the years. Look at Jose Mourinho. Only lasted 3 years before being taken over. Well, he resigned from his role. Massimiliano Allegri took over the reins. He stuck around for a good 13 years, picking up two league titles, 10 cups. We'll take a look at those in just a second. Before he was sacked back in 2033, Michael Donaldson, the famous Michael Donaldson, took over a caretaker role before Luis Enrique decided to take over the reins. 2 years and 71 days he lasted, picking up no major honours. It's only been a year, knocking on 2 years now, for Sergio Conceição as gaffer. Here's a quick overview of the cup situation. He picked up the League Cup in the first season, 2017-2018. And then once again, 2 years later, beat Man City in the final. A few years later down the road, knocking, taking out Liverpool along the way to cup glory. Meanwhile, in the FA Cup, again, in the 2017-2018, looks like you had a cracking season, picking up the FA Cup, beating Tottenham. Back-to-back wins in 2020-21 campaign, beating Leicester and Liverpool, respectively. Also beating Arsenal, 24-25 season, again knocking out Tottenham Hotspur in the final, 27-2018, and beating QPR in the 2030-2031 season. Two adventures in the European Cup, or the UEFA Cup, or whatever they call it these days, being eliminated in the semi-finals. Let's take a look at the Champions League. No Champions League success. Getting close, semi-final against Liverpool in that first season under Mourinho. Semi-finals once again, losing to Bayern. And Barcelona into the final, losing against Bayern, losing against Paris Saint-Germain. As for this season, you're still around in the semi-final, so potential glory there. So let's take a look at your best 11. Here we are. These are the players who, over the past 20 years, have been considered the best players. Paul Pogba's in there. You got Lindelof in there. David De Gea also. And a lot of unfamiliar names. So let's turn the clock back further and have a look from way back when. Who was your main man? Obviously, this is the campaign that we are in the present day. Lukaku, Mkhitaryan, Mata, Herrera, Pogba, a lot of familiar names. Then we start going forward. Luke Shaw's in there, Bailey's in there. And bit by bit, we start dropping off some players. Top goal scorer, who's this? Andre Silva, 27 goals. That's not a bad turnout. He seems to lead the line for a couple seasons. Lukaku's still knocking around. 23 goals in the 21-22 campaign. Kingsley Coman, he was part of the Manchester United books. Gabriel Barbosa as well on the right-hand side. So pretty dynamic starting 11 there. Juan Mata still knocking around. 22-23. So is David De Gea. As we kick on forward, De Silva still leading the line. Kingsley Coman, David De Gea still in the squad. Felix Lindelof, he must chalk up a few appearances if he's still around at 2026-2027 season. That's knocking on. So this is 10 years from now. Gabriel Barbosa, Lindelof, David De Gea still at the club. And then a whole mixed bunch of folks that we're not familiar with. 26 goals for Sergi Moreira. Also from midfield, Fabrice Simon, 24 goals. That's not a bad turnover. Switch of formation now, a bit of a defensive midfield slot. Fabian Perez, 22 goals. We have a new goalkeeper, Miguel Flores. Diaby's in there. A lot of unfamiliar names. Fabian Perez, 30 goals and a 4-4-2. And here we are overall. So I said, we'll turn the clock back. Felix Jorge, 642 appearances for United. Lindelof, 611. David De Gea, 567. Sort of top goal scorers over the years. Pogba got 135 in his duration. Fabrice Simon, 175. Rodrigo, 170. Let's take a look at some of the records. These are the most goals scored in the season. Fabian Perez got 30, 35, 36 season. Back on familiar terms, Lukaku with 26, Andre Silva 27 in the 2019-2020 campaign. Big numbers. Patrick Cutrone, he got 28 goals during the 25-26 season. As for who's creating them, who's creating the most goals? 25 assists from Andrea Scorciamilo on the 2030-2031 campaign. No one really gets close to him over the years. He also had a pretty decent season the season before, 23 assists. Juan Mata was consistent over a good portion of the time. Let's take a look at the fastest goals over the years. 10 seconds, Rodrigo against Stoke in the Premier League on Boxing Day. Sergio Mora also 10 seconds against Manchester City. That must have been a cracking afternoon. I'm not sure about the end result. 9 seconds, Lukaku against Southampton in the Premier League. 2021-22 campaign. Let's take a look at your youngest player. We have a 15-year-old, Vincent Tumba. Where is he these days? Clicking on him. He is at Aberdeen, 33 years old. Only one under-21 cap to his name. Bit of a decent scorer for them scumbags down the road, Burnley. Not really. Never really hit the major heights. In fact, looks like he returned to Manchester United for a second bite of the cherry. Let's have a look at that history a little bit. Oh, these were all loans. Looks like he was on the books for a while, loaned out. Never really took off for him. As for the oldest player, I'm sure De Gea is going to be in there. David De Gea, 37 years old. Marc-Andre ter Stegen, the current Barcelona keeper, made the switch to United over the years. What else? What else have we looked at? Let's have a look at the landmarks. Major landmarks over the season. Abramovich, point vice captain, Super Cup winners. Glazer leaves the board, I guess. New chairman Graham Ray takes over as with a consortium. Youth and training facilities upgraded. Pogba removed as captain. Lindelof appointed as captain. Changing of the guard there. What else? Club fail European Cup financial fair play regulations. It's controversial right there. New chairman. Neil Clark takes over. Floated on stock exchange. Graham Ray leaves. So he's your, let's have a look at the current staff. Chairman, Niall Clark, Jimmy Logan, Tim Draper. Any familiar names across the board? We obviously, look at this, former manager, Massimiliano Allegri is the director of football. And obviously you've got your manager. Where is he? Can't see him. There he is. Conte Sal. Nicky Butt, head of development. That's interesting. Kabayi, he's in your senior squad coach. Let's take a look at your transfers over the years. The first season, nothing too crazy in Manchester United's eyes. And then we had £32 million capture of Jose Calderon from Napoli. Meanwhile, the next season, you coughed up £70 million from Panjenic from Juventus. Kicking forward a couple more seasons, Kingsley Coman arrives from Bayern for £92 million. That's a monstrous fee, even if compared to some of the crazy figures that we're attached to today. Arturo Garcia, £70 million from Vigo. Another £71 million capture. Patrick Coutrone from Paris Saint-Germain. £79 million capture. Sean McKay from West Brom. Now, that's a bit tasty. £81 million capture from Turan Archie from Sevilla. And this season, Umberto Belletti from Real Madrid. How about on the other end, on the receiving end? First two seasons, nothing. Phil Jones goes to Napoli for just under £18 million. Romero off to Toulouse for just five. No major. Oh, here we go. Sergi Moreira off to Paris Saint-Germain for £113 million. That's your monster fee right there. No other major monster fees. Günther Frank goes to Monaco for just shy of £41 million. But that is pretty much it. So that's your lot, folks. If you enjoyed this video, give me a thumbs up. And if you haven't done so already, make sure you hit the subscribe button. Keep you bang up to date with all things Football Manager related. Over the next few weeks, I'm going to be preparing and getting ready to do my first game save. So stand by for that. But until next time, thumbs up. Ciao for now. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe. Check back for more FM content over the next few days. As for my Rovers fans, fear not, Blackburn Rovers content will always be my number one. So don't you go anywhere. Anyway, let's head back into the dugout for some more FM action.